nice. Food for Murmur. We got Suicide Thralls dropping in on the west side. Oh, where'd they go?
I'm gonna give you a hard Murmur.
That's what she said. I know.
You big one-eyed fuck wanna fuck with my boys? I'll bring you hard, like Jake motherfucking Steed. Not much you can do against zombie apocalypse nowadays. Fully modded up. Nice, I got a lot. I might even finish the bounty on that one. Let me check. I got a lot of thralls on that. I probably got 24 out of 25. 13 out of 25. Not bad. Yeah, I switched back to my old rig, so I'm a little tougher now that I have my old exotic gear switched around.
Oh, yeah, I forgot that was
going
to level 12.
Yeah, it was. Knock a couple bounties out, but not stressing over it. I mean, we can do a harder one, but I'd rather just do patrol instead of like trying to like milk them. Alright, let's just go right into here. I kind of want to finish up my strike requirements before I go back into the Crucible, because I know the next step in my exotic bounty is to do stuff in the Crucible. But you can never have too much Crucible practice. Like, every match is training, and every match is going to pay you something, yeah. Whether it's Crucible, marks, or it's actual stuff, you know. The better you do on the winning team, you know, the better you get, too. When we're on the losing team and we see, like, this sweet-ass reward come to the best of the worst, you gotta imagine what the worst of the best got. But Crucible's more about getting Crucible points and going and buying stuff and leveling up in that sense more than, you know, because you got Future War called Dead Orbit, New Monarchy, and the Crucible Vanguard Salesman that will sell you stuff using Crucible stuff, points, levels, and accommodations. Accommodations.
Find access to their system. See if we can track down Gallus Tara.
No hive on this one, fortunately.
Hold on, voice channel. You can talk to the allies you mentioned. First, let's select the engineer.
That came out a few updates ago. They came out with, like, you'd be able to talk to other people even if they're not on your fire team if you wanted.
Oh, alright. So it's kind of like a ring.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Like, if you're going with randoms, you can switch over to the strike team.
Or you can just, like, try to talk to somebody at the tower and say, instead of just sending them an invite, you can actually talk to them and be like, hey, I'm about to do this. Do you want to come do it? And...
yeah. Can you talk to all channels at once?
I don't know. I have no interest in talking to other people.
Yeah, only the people on the fire team.
I know. I'm just saying, like, if I want to call out to everyone in the vicinity for a distress signal or something like that, I want to, but I might be able to do that. Oh, there's
a chest right
here. I found the chest.
He was getting hit, oh shit, by two murmurs like every time.
Hey guys, there's a chest up here.
Go ahead and take it. We heard you the first three times.
Yeah. Yeah, just take one.
I took like three since we started this one without you guys. It's all good.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, it's just, it's one of those things, like, there's a little hidden cave over here, too. You know, we're on a strike, so, you know, looting's great, but, you know, to a point. You know. When I'm on patrol, I'll sit down and wait for people, but...
Yeah, we're on a strike.
Well, no, it's just, it's, it actually, it makes more sense to get them, wait for people on a strike than on patrol, because in patrol, you can go anywhere you want, and you don't have to stick together if you don't want to. You know. But I'm just, you know, I you know, people know how I am with a chest. There's always another one. They come, you know, it's nice to take one, but I'm not going to walk back more than 30 seconds to hold somebody up. I don't expect people to hold me up more. Watch that left flank. We're going to up on the hill there. All right, he's down. Hopefully. We're on the tiger list. I gotta grind out like five more strikes today.
I think in the next expansion pack we'll be able to get our third subclass.
I hope so. I wouldn't care if it's a mix, if it was a mix of both subclasses. I think that would actually be pretty cool.
Or maybe an entirely different one.
Yeah. Either way, it'll be the way it begins.
I want to try some of the new Crucible maps, so I think that'll be fun.
Oh yeah, we have yet to break those in.
No, because there's always somebody on the team that doesn't have the Dark Below.
And now, we can do...
Yeah.
That's one of the things, too, people are going to have to realize is a lot of Crucible, heavy Crucible players aren't going to want to stay behind for people that don't buy the DLC. And that's nothing strange, you know, it's Battlefield, that's all first-player FPSs, you know. People that are heavy into PvP stick with the common. I'm one of those people. I don't have any of the Battlefield DLC, so, like, I miss out on a lot of... People are like, oh, I'll play with you, but you don't have all of them, so I don't want to, you know, because I don't want to be missing out on 20 maps. I still hear one over here.
I like to describe people about how the game is divided between people who buy the DLC and people who don't.
Good news. I always separate games by the people that hang playing games like this with their penis hanging out and people that don't.
Yeah.
What?
All right, I'm switching to Icebreaker. I'll give you guys long-range support for this tank part. That's pretty much its best. Best right here with this one. Once we clear out this hangar.
Ow. Easy. Easy and I are gonna be the tag.
Woohoo! Okay, Icebreaker's regenerating the ammo now. I'm gonna work on the big guy, because I can snipe you from here.
Ooh! That guy was flying!
Yeah, that was Ryan Nova.
Yeah, I know.
One Centurion down.
Yeah, dodge that easily. She's good for him to get herself checked.
He turns to look at you guys, and I hit him with like 25 to 30,000 with each one of my icebreakers. damn, he's out of line of sight. Alright, here comes the next big wave, guys. Watch out.
Couple green engines around, but I'll grab that. Call me.
Turn my look sensitivity up here a little. It's getting dark out. Icebreaker just regenerates ammo.
Yeah.
So I'm just in back.
I had icebreaker.
Boom, 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 boom. Only sniper rifle I've ever used. Bought it once I hit like level 27.
Yeah, but he's immune to. Oh, never mind. I can hit him.
Valzruch is almost gone.
Yeah, I just met Citra for the first time.
Shit, I didn't shoot there. I just changed my look sensitivity. I'm trying to play around with it. Alright, they're both up in the tower.
That's what she said.
Shit. Damn it. Ugh. Totally missing that.
Valmar.
One's down.
Valmar.
Valmarug. He's totally looking up at Easy. God, look sensitive. This is not.
Icebreaker looks cool.
Yeah.
Looks like a gun from Halo.
Ooh, that's better right there. Look sensitivity 7. That's what I was looking for.
I'm picking up one of his lieutenants heading this way.
That was the looseness I needed. That's what he said.
Yep. I'm going back for another interceptor to use with the tank.
He's in a tank.
He's in a tank.
Ow! Back from the dead, motherfucker!
I jumped right over it. Yeah, you gotta dodge him.
It's kind of hard in a giant ass tank. It looks like my
L2 R2 strafe. That's the trick.
Ah, I didn't realize you could see the interception to do it. He tried to revive me, yet he grabbed the interception. He's safe. Or not. Or he didn't want to revive me.
Alright, I gotta regen.
I just respawned.
Icebreaker.